step is going to be applying to our dream companies. You know, maybe you're someone, you already know exactly which companies are your dream companies, but maybe they're, you know, you kind of don't know where to start, right? And you don't really know what those are yet. So we're going to go through some helpful ways. I'm going to share some helpful websites on how to research things that are important to you and, you know, really hone in on what is, you know, going to be your top priorities. This is a wonderful market to have a, you know, highly sought after skill set like software engineering. So, you know, I think it's hopefully, you know, out of this, you can start getting some really good, you know, insight and, you know, invitations to interview. All right. So I think everyone should have a career skills assignment spreadsheet. It will probably look like this. So this here, I'll delete these for a second. So this, your part one should look like this. Part two will look like this. And then we're going to go over a little bit in part three, tonight as well. So pull that up for a second. And if you don't have it, that's okay. Everything we do tonight, you can literally just open up your own spreadsheet, take your own notes. By no means is this required to, you know. All right, great. So open this up and we're going to start talking about our identifying our priorities, right? So that could include things like career growth might be a priority, what your day-to-day work life looks like, mission, compensation, culture, etc. So those are just some ideas, right? Some of those might resonate with you, some might not. So these might be a few priorities. So I'm interested to hear, what are some of the other priorities that you have, or has anyone thought of what their priorities are?
One of my priorities, I wasn't quite sure how specific the priorities had to be. So I put a priority saying be an innovator and be a tech expert in AI and data science. So I don't know if that's something that is too broad or that is something that needs to be more refined.
Well, I think that that depends on what your definition of that might be. So you said you want an opportunity to innovate and become a tech expert, correct?
Yes, correct, yeah.
To innovate, become tech expert. Yeah. So tell me, I mean, in your words, like, what does that mean to you? What is your definition of that?
What that means is that, you know, being an innovator, meaning that I, you know, as a researcher, so like being able to be having the open kind of range to be able to think about new ideas, new concepts, bringing technologies to the business. Becoming a tech expert, meaning that, you know, I'm the go-to person. So if the business requires some type of, you know, asking, you know, whether this technology is ready to be used to solve this particular problem, then I can go ahead and say, oh, yes, it is ready to be used, or no, it's not ready yet. We're still doing some evaluation. It's not ready for prime time. So kind of providing like some type of like a report, or being like a consultant, right, to the business to say that, you know, this is what we think of that. So that's what I mean by being a tech expert. But then, and then also being kind of the liaison between, let's say, the engineering or the technology teams or the research teams and the business. So basically taking what are the business requirements and then translating those in terms of what the technical capabilities are.
Sure. And some of those, that's going to come in helpful when you're looking at specific roles, right? So this is going to help guide a lot of your questions on, you know, making sure that your day to day or your, you know, work responsibilities include some of those things that you mentioned. I think so. Priority one, opportunity to innovate. Yeah. So I think when we're looking at companies, from what you're telling me, it sounds like you want a company who's going to be on the cutting edge of technologies, who's going to be innovative, maybe a company who's even helping to create new technologies, right? So it's not going to be somewhere that, you know, you have, working on legacy systems, obviously, for example.
Exactly.
Great. Yeah. Thank you for sharing. Anyone else have a priority that they'd like to share? All right, Peggy, I'm going to bring you on.
Hello.
Hi.
One of the most important things for me is that I have to work with a good team.
Okay.
Yeah, so being able to, like and trust the people that I work with. One of the biggest things to me in my role now is being able to have a good retro session. If you can't have a good retro session, I just don't think you can really develop effectively together.
Yeah. So being able to and trust people, good retro session, right? Might spell this wrong. Yeah, that's great. So you want to make sure that the company has a good collaborative type of environment, it sounds like.
Yeah.
Cool. Great. Thank you for sharing. Let's do one more. So Vanny, I'll go ahead and bring you on. Yep, go ahead.
Can I call it as a problem solver? I'm passionate about solving problems. So that's what my strength area is. I have a lot of job satisfaction doing that, solving the issues, both technical, strategic, process oriented. So, I can see many type of things, and I want to be a great advisor, leading.
Yeah.
So could that be one of the priority?
Okay. Yeah, great. I think these are all great priorities that we, sorry, Vanny, did I interrupt? Did you have anything else to add there?
No. Please go ahead.
Okay, cool. Yeah, thanks. Thanks for sharing. So I think these are all great priorities. They're a little bit more job specific to me. Can anyone think of a priority? And I think that everything that we've talked about so far is great when you go into an interview, because it's going to help guide your questions on, when you're in an interview, to really help dig into, does this team really solve complex problems, right? Is this going to be a good team environment? And are they innovative? What are some priorities that we can think of that are more company specific, right? So, we want career growth, a good mission, compensation. So let's try and get a little bit more generalized, because the point of this exercise is we want to drill down to a specific company. I feel these are great priorities to make sure that the role we're accepting is great. So can someone share a priority that maybe will help guide us in that? So Mimi shared, remote opportunities. That's one of my priorities when I'm looking for work, right? Remote work. I think the definition is, pretty self-explanatory. That might be one of your priorities. Vanny, I'll bring you on. Tell me one more.
I would say that career growth. I want career to growth. Myself in the leadership roles, a thought leader.
So career growth to you means you want to be a leader of an organization, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. So having vertical growth, becoming a leader. Cool. Now, so this is a good example. I think career growth is, Jagdeep says work-life balance. Yes, we can add that in too. Work-life balance. Yeah, that's a great one. Now, so career growth is a good one, I think, because it that could mean something different for different people. Like for me, I don't necessarily want to go into management. I really like what I do. I really like being a recruiter. I don't necessarily want to lead an organization. So career growth to me means I get to work on new and exciting roles, right? I don't just want to work on the same role forever. I want to be able to work on different types of positions and get to learn different types of technologies and get involved in, cross-functional projects. So, this is why the definition becomes so important, because, maybe if, you want to become a leader and that's a really, close goal for you, applying to companies that are very flat might not be the best route, right? Like, for example, I know Apple has an extremely flat organization. It might not be as easy to move up in Apple as it could be in, say, Amazon, right? Or Facebook. I don't know as much about those companies, but as just an example. So this is where it can help us kind of you know, guide what we want here. And then, yeah, I heard work-life balance as well. This means something different to a lot of people. I, for example, work-life balance to me means remote work. As long as I'm working from home, I am completely fine, right? Today, for example, I started work at 8 a.m. and I'm not going to get done until probably like 9 p.m. my time, mountain. I'm in mountain time. It's a really long day, but like it snowed a foot here and I didn't have to drive to an office and I got to hang out with my dog. So like it's fine, right? So, you know, really be clear on our definitions here as well. I think, Oleski, I'm going to bring you on here. I see your hand. Yeah, go ahead.
I have my motivation is compensation. I'll give you an example. I'm QA. I'm elite SDT for now. And I started as manual tester. And manual tester usually can earn approximately 60K or 80K or maximum 90K. And after I start learning automation step by step, API, UI, security, performance. And after I increase more and more my salary. And this is my motivation because I can double my salary every time. Yep. And automation tester usually take approximately 150K, 180K. But farm companies or unicorn startups, they can pay more. They can pay base, stocks, and plus some signing bonuses. It can be from 200K to 400K. This is definitely my motivation.
Yeah, that's why I think that's a great one. You know, a lot of companies will have, you know, for example, pre-IPO companies might have great opportunities to get in on the ground floor if they have stock options. So yeah, I think that's a really good example. Sorry, Alan, I think you had a bit to mention. So prestigious engineering organization, compensation, you know, want to, okay. So Alan, you're focusing on a particular vertical as well.